Sri Gurubhyo Namaha. Good morning viewers. In this video, we are going to see based on a chart how we can understand the human relationship. For each and every house, there is a significance that denotes a person's particular relationship. So we are going to see is a simple way on all the 12 houses, which are the houses indicates the relationship. If you are new to this channel, please keep the channel subscribed so that you can get my updates very instantly. The first house, we generally call it as ascendant. The house which denotes me, it is my personal house, where it indicates the characteristics of the chart holder. The second house indicates the family of the chart holder. It can be my family or the person who is holding the chart. The third house denotes the younger brothers and sisters of the particular chart holder. So we can say how they behave with me. My younger sisters or brothers, will they be helpful to me, or they don't show interest in my welfare? All these things can be predicted through the third house. When you see the fourth house, it relates to a mother. And generally it is mother and mother's family, we call like mothers, sisters, brothers, like that. So this house indicates whether your mother is very kind to you, or you will be benefited with your mother, like that. Fifth house denotes my children, that is the chart holder's children, and the chart holder's father's forefather, and their grandmothers, etc. So it is the forefathers of the father's side. And the sixth house indicates the uncle and uncle's family. So generally the sixth house is a separate one, where we get associated with the mother's side uncle and father's side uncle. Generally it is through mother's side uncle. So how better we will get benefited, all these things. The seventh house indicates the partners, that is the wife or husband. If the chart holder is a male, then his wife will be the seventh house. If the chart holder is a female, then her husband would be the seventh house. Also, it indicates the friends that you are going to get associated. The eighth house indicates the lifespan of the person's horoscope. See how long he is going to live. So the eighth house indicates the lifespan. Ninth house indicates the father and father's family. Generally, father, father's younger brothers and elder brothers, father, sisters, and all. The 10th house indicates the children that you are going to adopt in your life, and the servants who serve you right from your childhood. So this indicates the 10th house. 11th house indicates your elder brothers and elder sisters, how cooperative they are going to be with you. The 12th house indicates mothers, father and forefathers and grandmothers. So this is the basic scenario of how each and house denotes a relationship. Why we call this? Because when you see, the ninth house is the father's house. It indicates father. The ninth house from the ninth house is going to be your fifth house. So all the forefathers of father's side will fall under the fifth house. As per the Hindu mythology, we call that forefathers and father's side family, a person is going to give birth to the horoscope owner. Supposing if a person is getting a child, a male or female, they are from the forefather's side. So that is the reason we categorize the children in the fifth house. Similarly, the ninth house from the fourth house is going to be the 12th house. So all your mothers, forefathers and grandmothers will fall under the 12th house. That is the way you can relate how benefitable through your mother's side or your father's side, like this. So based on the planets available on these houses, we can easily say from this relationship, who will be cooperative, who will do good things to you, who will do bad things to you. Supposing if in a particular house, if there are Subhagraha, that is a positive planets are there, like Jupiter, Venus or Moon, like that, then we can say that you will going to get benefited out of those particular house, and the relationship will be very kind to you, and you can get a good returns from them. At the same time, if you have any Pavagraha or bad planets being seated like Saturn or Rahu, Kedu, like that, then we can say that particular Bhava is spoiled, that particular relationship is not benefitable to you. So this is a way you can predict through your chart who are all your neighbors, who are all your relations, and how better you can be with them, and how the benefitable you are going to get from those relationships. So this is an overview. I think most of you might have known this. I thought it's a very crisp and a short video. Same way, I'll try to present some other interesting information in Vedic astrology. And see you then. Bye.